Welcome back to the BlockBench tutorial for real estate model. Today we'll be looking at the animation tab and make an animation together. At the bottom of your screen you can see a timeline. This is where you're going to work on your animations. You can change the length of your current animation by following this line. On the left side of your screen, there's a bit of space for where the animations will be. You can add a new animation by pressing this button, and you can also import animations. When you make an animation, you can choose where to stop at the end of the animation, or you can make it keep going in a loop. You can also easily change the loop mode by right-clicking the animation. If you change the snapping, you can get more or less space between keyframes. For your state model, there are some animation groups, like the main animation, arm animation, and also some animations for compatible mods. As something new, there's even arrow animations for when you make your own arrows. What you need to do when animating is override the default animations. If there are some animations that you don't make, the default animations will be used instead. So it might look a bit weird when your model isn't exactly like the default model. When you move a part of your model, a keyframe will appear on your timeline. You can also press one of these buttons to add a keyframe. The keyframes are separated into three categories, so it will be easier for you to work with them. You can also filter the keyframes if you feel that the timeline is getting a bit too crowded. And if you press this button, it will clear the keyframes. If you need to select all the keyframes, you can press this button and then press Ctrl A. Then there's this button which makes it possible to add effects. In the new update, Estate Model became compatible with sound effects, so you can add sounds to your animations. The instruct effect is used for making some math, but I'll save that for another time. If you open this keyframe window, you can see how the keyframe you're selecting has been changed. You can also change the keyframe's interpolation. For example, when you make smooth keyframes, they'll move a bit more. When you make animations, you might accidentally make them too long or too short, so it just doesn't look right. An easy way to fix this is by selecting all the keyframes with Ctrl A, and then dragging them while holding down Ctrl, so you don't have to spend a lot of time rearranging the keyframes. Another thing that might happen is that the end of the animation doesn't line up with the beginning of it. First, make sure all your keyframes are visible, and then copy the first keyframes. Then you can skip ahead to the end of the animation and paste the keyframes down. Let's try making a blinking animation. There are a lot of animations to choose from in the main animation file, but there aren't any called blinking. Instead, you can use a free parallel animation. The animation will constantly be active, so you don't have to add blinking to the other animations. There are also parallel animations, which are similar to the free parallel animations. The only difference is that the parallel animations override other animations. So if you use a parallel animation for your blinking animation, your model will also be blinking in the sleeping animation, even if its eyes are closed there. I'll make the new animation about 4 seconds long. Then around the beginning of the animation, I'll make it look like the eyes are closed by moving down the eyelash and hiding some of the eye. I'll also hide the lower part of the eyelash so it looks more flat. I think the step option might work well for this part, so let's try it out. To mirror the keyframes from one eye to the other, you can copy the keyframes from the one side and then paste them to the other side. Then you can press keyframe at the top of your screen and mirror them like this. And that's how to make a simple blinking animation. Now for the rest of the animations, you can check out the default model for guidance, and also make sure you check out the animations for the compatible mods. You can find the animations in the default model's animation folder.